بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم dear viewers. Today we start our lecture from a question that what we will learn in today's lecture. Answer: we will understand two definitions of infimum of a set and supremum of a set. Now recall from lecture number 14, the last lecture, that suppose if we have been given a set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then of course 5 is the maximum element of this set, and moreover supremum of this set is also 5. You can see maximum and supremum, they are the same in this case, and minimum of this set is 1, and also infimum of this set is also 1. And if we take the set A is equal to 1 over 5 open interval, in that case supremum is 5 and infimum is 1, but this set has no maximum, does not exist, and minimum also does not exist. Also recall from lecture number 14 that how we calculated the supremum of a set, that least of upper bounds of A, the least of upper bounds of A, and upper bounds of A, the upper bounds mean the number elements, numbers which are greater than or equal to the elements of this set, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, these are all the upper bounds of this set. And least among these all, least of all these numbers, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is 5. This is what we have discussed in last lecture. Similarly, infimum of a set, how we calculate infimum? Infimum is equal to greatest of lower bounds of A. Lower bounds mean numbers which are less than or equal to the elements of this set. For example, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, all these numbers which are less than or equal to the elements of a set is are termed as lower bound. And greatest among those lower bounds was defined as infimum of the set. You can see the last lecture, lecture number 14. So greatest of minus infinity to 1, and of course the infimum we calculated in the last lecture was 1. Now we need a definition more abstract which can be utilized in theorems. You know, we have a definition for supremum of a set, and this is like least of upper bounds of a set, and infimum is greatest of lower bounds, but we need some abstract sort of definition which can be used in theorems and which is more applicable to understand and to get the definition for the least upper bound of a set and the greatest lower bound of a set. We consider a dam consist of water, and these are the protective walls constructed to prevent water from flowing. This is the first wall from above, this is the first wall to stop the water, this is the second wall, this is the third wall, these are the upper walls to stop the water from flowing in this direction, and this is the water is touching this wall, and you know these are the upper walls to stop the water. And this is the least of these walls, the first one, you know, the least in upper walls. So I have colored this red because these are important for us, this wall from above and this wall from below. Similarly, these are the lower walls constructed to prevent water from this direction. This is the first wall to stop the water, second wall, third wall, and so on. Okay. Now assume that this water, from this water we means this set A, 1, 2, 3, and this water represent the elements of this set. And of course, the first wall is 3. We know that this set is not going beyond 3. From above, this is set A, 1, 2, 3, and we go, this 3 is the first wall to stop this set, to stop this water, you can see like. So 3 is represent this red wall. And these are the upper walls, upper bounds of this set, 4, 5, 6, but of course 3 is the least of upper bounds. So this is the supremum of this set. Supremum of this set is of course 3. Okay, now of course we know that the 3 is the supremum of this set, but we want to make a definition for this. How? We analyze two properties from this particular example, that what this 3, which is the supremum or least of upper bounds. We know that 3 is the supremum or least upper bound, but what the properties it possesses? Okay, property number first is that all the element of this set are smaller than this element. Like 1 is smaller than this, 2 is smaller than this, 3 is smaller than or equal to this. So what we grab the first, this property to make a definition for a least upper bound. Suppose if a number to be a least upper bound, all element of a set, this x represent elements of a set, should be less than or equal to that element. Okay, so this is the first condition we grab. Now what the second property this supremum of this set have? If you see, if I subtract a small number from this 3, which is actually supremum of this set, let's see what will happen. If we subtract a small number, 3 minus epsilon, epsilon mean that any positive number. If you subtract a small number from this 3, of course we will get a new wall over here. This is, this represents this 3 minus epsilon. And you can see that this is not a protective wall now, because the water, this, you know, have crossed this wall. So it means that because we have an element, if you see in the context of a set, if in a context of a water, you see water flow over here, you know, have crossed the wall. And in terms of a set, you can see that there is an element of this set which is on that side, and they, of course, it is 3. So we have observed two properties in the supremum of a set. What we have observed? Now this is first property a supremum has, that all elements are smaller than that element. And the second property we have observed, that if you subtract a small number from the supremum of a set, then it will be no more, the new wall, the new number will be no more the upper bound, and you will see water will cross it and will flow here. That is, there will be at least one element of the set which will be on that side. So this is the property of a supremum of a set. So now we are in a position to give a definition to the supremum of a set. Now here is the definition of a supremum of a set. If you see, what is it? Least upper bound or supremum of a set. Let A be a subset of R, then a number M is said to be the supremum or least upper bound, L least L upper and bound of a set. If M possesses two properties, that is, number one, all the element of the set should be smaller than or equal to that element for all x belong to A. And second condition, second property is that for any epsilon greater than 0, there exists at least one element in the set such that M minus epsilon is less than A. It means that if you subtract any positive number from this candidate to be a supremum, if you subtract even a small number from it, so that it remain no more an upper bound, and you know the water flows to that side, mean that there is at least one element in that set which comes to that side. So this is definition of the supremum of a set. Okay, in similar way, if you see that we know that one is the greatest of lower bounds. Of course, these are the lower bounds of this set, stopping this set, bounding this set from this side, from lower side. What are the lower bounds of this set? 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. We know that this set is not going beyond these numbers. So, and 1 is the greatest of these lower bounds. Now we see what are the properties this lower bound, this greatest lower bound is having, so that we can make a definition. Number one is that one property this infimum of this set have. Number one, you can see all the elements of this set are greater than this or equal to this. For example, 3 is greater than or equal to 3 is greater than 1, yes. 2 is greater than 1, yes. And 1 is greater than or equal to, yes. So it means that this one is having one property, that this is smaller than or equal to all the elements. So one property this infimum is having. Okay, now what is the second property this infimum is having, so that we can construct a definition based on these observation, a general definition based on these observation. First observation, what is the second observation? If you add any positive number to it, in supremum we have subtracted, and in infimum we are adding. If we add even a small number to this one, I mean that 1 plus epsilon. Epsilon mean any positive number. If you add any positive number, so you will get a new wall. 1 plus epsilon represent this new wall. And you can see, now this wall is no more a protective wall, because you can see water is here. What do you mean by water? I mean that there is, we know that at least one element of this set is on that side. And this is not more any upper bound. So a greatest upper bound, greatest lower bound, you know, GLB, is one that if you little move over here, so it will be no more a GLB, a new number. So we got two properties, that if you add something with it, there will be elements of a set which will be on that side. And you know, in this particular example, we have one over here. So now we are going to define infimum in this way. Okay, this is the definition of a greatest lower bound or infimum of a set. Let A be a subset of R, then a number M is said to be GLB, that is greatest lower bound or infimum of set A, if this number possesses two properties. It satisfies two properties. Number one, M is less than or equal to X for all X belong to A, that is all element of the set are greater than or equal to this element. And number two, if you take any positive number and you add with this candidate, then there exists at least one element in the set which is on that side, which is smaller than M plus epsilon. If a candidate, if a number satisfies these two conditions, then we will say that it is actually infimum of that set. So if you have any question, I will be thankful for asking.